Harpers, do you ever struggle with placing or what fingerings to use? Let's talk. I had a question recently on my Clergy's Lament video that reads, when playing Celtic music, do you change the ornamentation on the fly? And if so, how do you anticipate that change when placing your fingers? Placing is why I have difficulties improvising on the harp. So thank you for that question. I thought it was so good that we're gonna have a video about it. I'm going to be using the Clergy's Lament as an example, which by the way, we will have a tutorial for this tune next week. It is on my new album, one of the tracks on my new album. So I'm going to play the first part here, and when we get to this ornamentation, I'll stop. So right there I do just a little turnaround. And when I'm doing that, I know I need to place fingers 1, 2, and 3. All that is I'm going back to the B. Very quickly. And this passage would be the same whether or not I do that ornament or not. Here it is without. That's it without the ornament, and it's still fingers 1, 2, and 3 on the same strings. Whether we do A, B, A, G, or A, B, A, B, A, G. So it's still the same fingering. So if I want to put it in, I don't have to think too much. If I want to leave it out, that's fine too. It works either way. A lot of the times ornaments will be like that. They'll be the same fingering whether or not you put them in. And it's the same thing for a cut. If I was doing just A, B, A, G, I'm still using fingers 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. If I was to add a little cut ornament right before the A, which is just an extra B with my thumb, it's still the same fingering. It's still one, I just add an extra one in there. So I could play this same passage three different ways, all with the same fingers. At least three. If you come up with any more, let me know. So I could do, like we did before, without the ornament. I could do with that little turn ornament. Or I could do it with the cut. It's still the same three fingers, and I don't have to replace or rethink any of them. So that's quite nice. If you want to get fluid with playing ornaments on the fly, I would study several different types of ornamentation and see how many finger combinations they can be played with. Some might be one way is the only one that makes sense, and some might be two or three ways. For example, if you were doing this trill, which is just three fingers on the same string. Now, you can play that with fingers 3, 2, and 1, or you can do 4, 3, 2. Either way is fine, and it depends on what tune you're playing and what comes before and after. That would help you decide which way makes the most sense. I'm going to post a couple of links below in the description, so make sure at the bottom of this video where it says show more, click on that so you can see what I'm talking about. I'll post a couple of links to books that I have heard talk about Irish and Scottish ornamentation. One is by Grania Hambly and the other is by Alison Kinnaird. I don't have these, but you can check them out for yourself. And by the way, give this video a thumbs up or tell me in the comments below if you would like me to do a video just on ornamentation, sort of an ornament tutorial. So different ornamentation usually has one or maybe two kinds of fingering that you would use with it and use the same one all the time. And you can take that same principle and apply it to your melody playing and to your left hand chords. So you find out what makes the most sense for you. Again, as to what comes before and after, and you play it that way every time. For example, in my last video lesson, Siogan, there is a very specific fingering for most of it. so that we're very connected and don't get lost. But there are a few times where you could have choices. For example, in that passage, you could do fingers 1, 2, 1, 2. You could also do fingers 1, 2, 1, 3. Right after that, we're doing a 3, 2, 1 on that same note you just left. So it might be easier for you to put a 3 there. It might be easier for you to place a 2 there. So it's, in those cases, it's kind of what makes sense to you and what flows better to you. And it doesn't really matter that much. There's not necessarily a right and a wrong way of playing it. But sometimes there are ways that make a lot more sense. Same with the left hand. Sometimes we use triads a lot when playing the harp. We know that triads are basically always played. It makes pretty much the most sense to use fingers 3, 2, and 1 because they're so close together. It's not a huge stretch to use 3, 2, and 1. You're not stretching from way down here to way up here. So anytime you need to place a triad, you know that that's the position you use. There's just one string in between. String, skip a string, string, skip a string, string. And we know we can always use fingers 3, 2, and 1 for that position. If you're playing a fifth, we use a lot of fifths in Celtic music. A fifth is really just a triad with the middle removed. So it makes the most sense for you to use fingers 1 and 3. It's a little less of a stretch than 1 and 2. And if you ever want to place an extra note or that middle note of the triad, your second finger is free to do so. So it makes a lot more sense to do fifths with fingers 1 and 3. And likewise with a 1-5-8 chord, I know that that would normally be played 4-2-1. We have a fifth at the bottom. For example, right here it's a C and a G. But then we also have a C at the top. So it's an interval of a fifth, and then from the middle, a fourth. And you probably don't want to use your third finger to reach all the way down to that fifth. That's a bit of a stretch, especially if you have a harp with wider spacing like mine. So try doing it, getting used to doing that with your fourth finger. And then just place your two, leave your three hanging, place your two on the fifth. And that way your thumb is free to take the top fourth, or that octave. And again, it makes the most sense that way because this is the way we play octaves, with 1 and 4. 4-2-1. So get used to that position, because we do use 1-5-8ths quite a lot, again, in Celtic music. So you could practice just going from one chord to the next, the exact same shape, and exact same fingering, 4-2-1. And it helps too to try and place it with your hand at the correct angle, coming straight to the strings this way, instead of placing this way and swooping down. So get used to coming to the strings, grabbing them that way, straight from the side, and try to place them all at once if you can. So that's another common fingering, one that probably makes the most sense. Same idea with if you were going to do, say, a 1-5-10, or any big chord like this, where you have a lot of strings in between each finger. 4-2-1 will usually make the most sense. Also remember, you don't have to place everything every time. If you're doing a very large chord, like C, G, E at the top, you can place the bottom two, 4 and 2, fingers 4 and 2, and then as you're about to play 2, roll up to the high note. so that you can reach it and not stretch your hand out too much. That's perfectly acceptable. So again, having some standard fingerings like that, that you have worked on and are used to, and that make the most sense, can help you in improvising, because if I'm playing a tune and I know, let me just play some 1/5/8ths and I know a C is here, if I'm reading a lead sheet maybe, an F is next, and then you could switch to a triad. But that's all for another video, we'll talk about that later. But good fingering and connections are something I try to convey in my harp tutorials. So if you struggle with that, why not come and visit my Patreon page? Because if you didn't know, every single tutorial that I put out here on YouTube once a month also has two extra lesson videos that go along with it. And those are available as part of a Patreon subscription. It can be really helpful just to see it done and hear it done. There is a link in the comments and also in the description, and you can check out the different levels of membership there. At last count, I was counting just an hour or so ago, there are over 30 extra tutorials right now over on Patreon, and depending on what level you're on, you can get access to all of those. If you're on the intermediate level, you can watch them as many times as you wish. You can pause them, slow them down, and they are there for the viewing for as long as you are a member. So that might be something you want to check out. Today's comment question, tell me down below, do you use ornamentation in your harp playing? If so, do you have a favorite one that you use a lot? Thanks so much for watching. Check out right up there on my Patreon page, and hopefully that'll be some help to you. And check out some more tutorials over here. And I will see you next week with a new tutorial and sheet music. Bye!